has always been a mystery. All my life I've been told I belong at the end of the line. Will all the other not quite? Will all the never get it right? But it turns out they're the ones you were looking for all this time. 'Cause I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul ever since you rescued me.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning to this Friday here in the heart of the Arkansas Delta. It is so good to see everybody this morning. I hope that you have had a good week thus far. I hope you had a great Thursday. Man, oh man, we had a gorgeous day yesterday. You know, it was a little cool. I worked outside all day long and it was a bit on the cool side, but you know, all in all, it was just pretty, just a pretty, pretty day. Hey folks, come on in, say hello. Let's get our Friday started. Let's get our weekend kick started. Let me know that you're here. Go ahead and click that share button when you do. And then let's get our friends and family involved. And we are going to have a good old-fashioned Friday coffee chat. We are ready to get it done. Get it going, y'all. Hope your coffee is strong this morning. Mine needs to be a bit on the stronger side. I am dragging today. Matter of fact, to be completely honest with you, and I do mean completely honest with you, I've just about overdone it yesterday. We worked yesterday at our new home that we're moving into in Wynn, and Miss Denise worked all on the inside, and I worked all on the outside, and no kidding, y'all, I mowed the yard twice. The yard was in rough, rough shape, and so I push mowed it twice just to get it done and get it cleaned up and done some trimming and pulling and just all kinds of stuff. And I am just about three levels of war smack out. So I'm dragging. I'm struggling to focus. My eyes are burning. So in case I'm looking at you funny, don't think nothing. That's exactly what it was. But you know, it's a nice place. It's a great neighborhood. But the yard was just very much unkempt. The house was unkempt. And so Miss Denise has turned the house upside down, cleaning it, and I have turned the yard upside down, working in it. And I'm nowhere near done, but at least we got it started so that we can get in it and do some deeper cleaning once we get inside. This coming week is move-in week. We're not 100% sure what day. I've got a target date, but we're not 100% sure. So what we want to do, and I'm just going to go ahead and throw this out at you, we will be here for our morning chat. We will be here Monday and Tuesday, all right? Listen up, Monday and Tuesday. After that, we're probably not going to be here due to the moving schedule. Got to get loaded in next week. I've got to get there. We're going to be losing, obviously, we're going to be losing the internet service and getting it transferred and all of that good stuff. So let's plan on Monday and Tuesday. Make sure you're here. And then just stay abreast as to what we're going to be doing from that point on. Okay, I am almost over there so I can see who all is hanging out. There is Miss Sandy. Good morning, Miss Sandy. How are you doing, lady? There's Tommy and Arlene. Good morning. There's Mary Fields. Good morning, Mary. Glad you're back with us today. Glad you are now making the chat a part of your morning. We have so much fun hanging out around here. It is just good to be here. If you're sneaking on in, don't be shy. Go ahead and say hello. Let me know that you're here. Let me know what's going on. I woke up to 39 degrees this morning, but y'all, there is rain and storms in the state. If you have not seen it, it is here. And it looks like we may see it over here in our part of the Delta around 1 o'clock. So you want to keep an eye on that. It is coming across the north western corner. It kind of looks a little weird. I'm actually looking at it now on radar, and I'm suspecting we're going to see some of it about 1 o'clock. So if you have got some errands to run, you want to get it done today, this morning, okay, before all of that hits. But you know, I was looking back at my memories on Facebook this morning, and 2 years ago today, 2 years ago today, here in the heart of the Arkansas Delta, it was 19. 19 with a wind chill of 3, y'all. Yes. 19 with a wind chill of 3. So I will take 39 any old day. You got to be careful again. You got to be careful with the rain and the storms that's coming in. So we want to make sure that we watch that. Our morning Bible verses, we're continuing in our reading of daily gratitude. We are in Matthew 26, verse 27. Jesus is instilling the Lord's Supper. And so we're going to get a passage out of the Lord's Supper. So this is Matthew 26, verse 27. It says, then he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to them, saying, drink from it, all of you. So that is our morning. That is our morning verse. And we just want to say thank you for that as we are continuing in daily gratitude. Daily gratitude. So how was everybody's Thursday? I've already told you about mine. Pretty much overdone it. Literally walked that yard twice. It was just, I am whooped, y'all. I'm not even kidding. And I got a mulching mower, so it wasn't blowing it all out. It was taking its time and just mulching. I mean, it looks great when I got done with it, but dear goodness. Woo, man, oh, man. And it was a hard one. But I got to get some studying in today. Got to get that sermon rocking and rolling. Hey, hope you guys can join us on Sunday. Coffee bar and our praise and worship rehearsal is going to start at 8:30. You can come on in and just do fellowship together, do life together. That's at 8:30, 9:30 is Sunday school, and at 10:30 is our morning worship. So that is all Sunday. And then, again, we will be here for our morning chat. We'll be here Monday and Tuesday. All right, Monday and Tuesday, you can lock it down. But after that, you probably won't see me for another week or so, okay? Because I've got to get moved in. I got to get all of that stuff done. I got to get my internet moved, my office set up, all of that. I'm not real sure about our nightly broadcast. I'm pretty much 100% sure on the Wednesday night, but I'm not real sure on everything else. So you're just going to have to stick with me, y'all. Got to just stick with me. Stay close. Stay listening. Also, if I posted this yesterday, if you have not already went over and liked or joined my ministry page, you need to get over there and do that. That's real simple. Facebook.com/Jim Whaley Ministry. I posted a link to that yesterday. So get on over there and make sure that you click the like button so that you will be in the know when we get started over there. Today, Annie Ann's food truck is here in Forest City from 11 to 4 today and tomorrow. They're going to be up on Washington 2006, I think was the address. They're next to Sleep Cheap. I want to think that's somewhere up close to Walgreens up in that area. So if you are got a hankering for a Auntie Anne's pretzel, whether it's cinnamon sugar, them things are just so good. Or whether you just want one to dip in mustard or you just want all kinds of good stuff. It is here from 11 to 4. So make your way up there. You want to go early so that you can get it and get back home before the rain starts. Let's see here. Got several things I want to talk about. Today's going to be pretty much food related, which is kind of fun. A company called Goo, G-U, and I will guarantee you I'm mispronouncing that because it has a weird pronunciation. But it's G-U, and I'm just going to call it Goo for Friday here. They have announced a chocolate orange cheesecake for the holidays. Now, I'll tell you, this is one of Miss Denise's favorite holiday things is this orange, okay, that is coated in chocolate. Have y'all ever seen it? It's a candy, but it's a chocolate orange. You literally can peel it back by the layers just like you would an orange, and on the inside it has orange filling. Mr. Nation, remember them? And those are amazing. And so when I saw the picture of this thing, it gave me that impression that it might taste just like that along with the cheesecake. So Goo is releasing a chocolate orange cheesecake for the holidays. I would actually like to try that. I like orange, I like chocolate, and I love cheesecake. So I think that would be good. How many of y'all put candy canes on your Christmas tree? Or maybe you put them in stockings or tie them to gifts or something. How many of you use Christmas candy canes? I'd love to know. You know, people use candy canes for so many different uses. They'll tie them up as part of a bow on a package, and so it gives out that way. It's attached in a gift bag to go away. People put them in stockings. They hang them on trees. They hang them up and down. Miss Sandy says, I do. Okay. Who else? Does anybody else do candy canes? I like the candy canes. I really do. Brock's, the Brock's Candy Company, has announced that they are releasing a brand new holiday candy cane flavor. And I think I might like this. It is Funfetti cane. Now, I love a Funfetti cake. You know, it's almost kind of like vanilla cream, and then it's got sprinkles and stuff in it. Y'all have had a Funfetti cake. I know you have. Well, this is a Funfetti Christmas cane. Boxes of these dudes. And I think I would like to. I do what I don't eat. Yeah, see, that's what I'm talking about, Arlene. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Well, Brock's is putting it out. It should, matter of fact, we're this close to Thanksgiving. It should already be out. So if you get one, try it. Let me know how you enjoy it, okay? Let me know. Hey, let me ask you this. And I read a lot about these things. Let's see. Mary says, I have used candy canes lots of times on trees. Yes, yes. A lot of people do that. They'll use candy canes and it'll be like a last item on the tree type thing. So a lot of people let their kids do that and to decorate. You see, I mean, it's a precious thing. And there's candy canes in every flavor known to man, and it really is. And so I was really kind of excited when I saw this. I love the Funfetti taste. So to me, this was just kind of good. I was just kind of excited. I hear a lot about these next things, and I would just love to know if you have tried any. I would love to know what your thoughts are. And these are something that is called hot chocolate bombs. Hot chocolate bombs. Now, they're crafted. They're like a little ball, okay? And the ball is made of chocolate, but inside the ball is different things. And evidently, the way it works is you put this hot chocolate bomb in a cup of hot milk that you've already heated, and then as the bomb gets into the hot milk, it begins to melt and begins to mix. And so you can get all kinds of flavors of that. Have y'all ever tried one of those things? And I help her. Tommy, why did I ever doubt that? I know you help her. Yes. Hot chocolate bombs. Have you ever tried that? And they're all kinds of different flavors. I mean, all kinds of different things that are inside these dudes. The pastor at Wheatley Baptist Church, his name is Marty Wages. Marty's wife, and for the life of me, I can't remember her name. Marty's wife has opened her own sweet shop. She makes desserts and baked goods and candies. And she has started, you know, making some of these different hot chocolate bombs. And I read an article on them this morning, and I thought, well, we just need to talk about these. Has anybody tried one? Now, I like good hot chocolate, but I like to make it. And I don't like to use the powder. I'm not talking about getting the Swiss mix and ripping the package, open it, and throwing it. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking the real deal hot chocolate. Matter of fact, one of our favorite things that we have done over the years is for Christmas morning is at our house, we'll have a hot chocolate bar. We'll have, you know, the hot chocolate ready to go and then all kinds of things that you can put in it. And those have been fun for us over the years, but I love it. Arlene says, no, she has not tried them. They really look exciting. I mean, they really do. I'm not trying to say anything bad about them. They look exciting. I've just never tried one. But it's all geared to hot chocolate. And so, if you happen to try one, you know, you need to let your preacher know, you know, how it is, how it worked, all that good stuff. Give us a review. Okay. Give us the 411 as to what all that thing is. I would love to try one. I really would. But again, if I'm making hot chocolate, I've got my own special recipe that I use. I developed my recipe when we owned our coffee shop, and I developed it. And it is a tried and true hot chocolate that I promise you, if you were to ever drink my hot chocolate, you would never drink another one the same again. And I will guarantee that. It is amazing. Let's see, Tom, when we were kids, we used to make snuff out of sugar and Hershey's. Yes, I remember that. But like I said, I love good hot chocolate, but it's got to be made the right way. Now, of course, I'll take a Keurig cup of hot chocolate every now and then, you know, just to get my taste buds going. Or I'll grab a package or two of Swiss Mix and make one. But if I want real deal, and I do mean real deal hot chocolate, I want to make it myself from, you know, individual ingredients. And it is just so good. I'm talking good enough to hop up on the top of the house and holler hallelujah. I mean, it's good. Amen, Miss Denise? And I even developed a frozen hot chocolate, if you can believe that. Same taste, it's just frozen. So good stuff. Such good stuff. But I don't have the machines to do that here. Of course, I sold them all when I sold my business. But man, good stuff. Hot chocolate bombs. Anybody tries that, you got to holler at me, all right? Anybody tries it, you got to holler at me. Hey, that'd be good to be on my Christmas list. Y'all can get me a couple of them. Remember, I have a Christmas list if y'all need help getting me Christmas gifts. That's no problem. Today is November the 12th. It is officially National French Dip Day. National French Dip Day. Now, I don't know any French dips, but I know a whole bunch of American dips. That's all I'm going to say about that. I know a whole lot of them. No, French Dip Day. A good au jus is good, especially, you know, back when we were eating red meat, you get a good roast beef sandwich and a good French au jus sauce to dip that thing in. Wow, make you smack your mama. I mean, good stuff. So this will be a good day to go do that. Some sandwich places still do that. They offer an au jus on the side. I don't remember which ones, again, because I don't eat it. I think it's Arby's. I think it's Arby's offers a roast beef with a au jus sauce on the side. But that would be today. But now we're talking, okay? Now we're getting down to where I'm in the business. Today is National, you ready for this? Pizza with the works except anchovies Day. I'm talking everything in the kitchen except the anchovies going on the pizza. Now, that is what I'm talking about. I remember back when I managed pizza, the pizza places in Jonesboro. Actually, I was a traveling troubleshooter. We had two pizzas on the menu that pretty much had everything on it. One was called, let me see, Thomas says, send me your Christmas list, and when I get through with your birthday list, I'll get right on it. I will take care of that. Yes, I will. Pizza Inn had two really good, basically everything on it, pizzas. One was called the Special. One was called the Pizza Inn Special. And here's what that pizza consisted of. It was a little bit of hamburger meat. It was a little bit of sausage. And it had all the veggies on it. Okay? And that was always served best on a thin crust, in my opinion. And we sold a bunch of them. But their top-of-the-line pizza at Pizza Inn is something called the Monster. It is the Monster Pizza, and it is best on a thick crust. And here's how the Monster is made. Y'all, this was one of my favorite pizzas. Of course, this was back when I was eating red meat. I ate all of that. And so, generally, a New York-style crust was always the best. Get that layer of sauce. You get a layer of mozzarella on top of that. And then you got a layer of cheddar cheese on top of that. All right. Then you got pepperoni. You got Canadian bacon. Then you got hamburger. Then you got sausage. Okay. And then you got every vegetable you could think of put on top of that, dude. I mean, all piled up. And like I said, this is a thick pizza. And then once that's all said and done on top and kind of leveled out, then another layer another full layer of mozzarella on top of it that covered it all up, and then sprinkles of cheddar on top of that and throw it in. And of course, you could always add anchovies. And I can eat anchovies. It's like eating a ball of salt, if you just want to know the truth. They have no flavor. It's all salt. But the monster was always my favorite. And jeez, oh my gosh. It was so good. But like I said, it had everything in it but the kitchen sink. And then we chipped off some of the porcelain just to go on that dude. But yeah, the Pizza Inn Monster, if you're into something like that, that is the pizza you want. But you really want to appreciate it on a thick crust. Okay? A thick crust pizza with that. Now, and you know, we had several. And I'm a bread person. I can judge pizza by the bread. Look here. Look. Now I want pizza. Cheese pizza. That's right. Mr. Neese wants all the cheese pizza. Arlene says, I've gone to the kitchen. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Arlene's in the kitchen. What you making there, girl? But no kidding. A monster pizza. If you go, just think about Jim. Just think about me because they are so good. And you know, back this was back when I was still, you know, pretty good sized fella. And this is one of those things y'all don't really know about me. I have lost so much weight, it's not even funny. When we made our lifestyle change back, we're pushing 20 years now. You know, we stopped eating red meat. We stopped eating pork. We did a few other different things. And we changed our eating schedule and our eating habits and so on and so forth. And I dropped a ton, a ton of weight. And thank the Lord, all glory to Him, I've been able to keep that off and to stay physically in shape. And same thing with Mrs. Denise a year ago when she had to go in the hospital. We had to make some changes there, and she's dropped a blooming ton of weight. So it's all about the lifestyle change. It's not so much a diet, it's a lifestyle change, because I wouldn't change my diet for anything. I love chicken. I love chicken. I love turkey. I love seafood, okay? I mean, I do. And so people talk to me and they look at me like, well, you're missing out on the good stuff. No, I'm really not. I can go out to eat with anybody who sits across from me and eats a steak or eats barbecue. I love the aroma. I really do. But I wouldn't dare eat that stuff anymore because I know what it does to my body. And so I was blessed to be able to make that change, and I'm thankful for a doctor who called me on it. And so was so blessed to be able to do that. And there ain't nothing better than a good old-fashioned chicken. I mean a good old-fashioned Baptist burger. And speaking of, I hope all y'all got some fried chicken sandwiches this week, because we celebrated that. What was that, Tuesday? Tuesday, National Fried Chicken Sandwich Day. Tommy, did you get to go to Popeye's? I thought about that all blessed week, and I've just never went. I think if I ever did, I sure wouldn't get it. If I'd have went yesterday, I would not have got my yard done. That's all I'm going to say about that. Hey, I think Brian Ponder snuck in. Brian, you awake? Good morning, brother. Good morning. Good morning. All right. Like I said, it is a gorgeous day right now. The sun is shining in my office window. It is pretty, but as I look at the weather radar, folks, I'm not kidding you, okay, we are going to get some water today. Some of us will get more than others, but it is almost into Little Rock right now, rolling right at us. So if you've got errands to run, you get out. Tommy says, yes, I did. My coupon had expired, so I had a meal. Glory. Just glory, hallelujah. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Go do that. Hey, if you know Jenny Hanner, for those of you Ridgewood peeps, if you know Jenny Hanner, tomorrow is her birthday. So ring her up. Give her a call. Tell her happy birthday. Tell her that her preacher put her out there on Facebook today. Yep, tomorrow, the 13th of November, is Jenny Hanner's birthday. So make sure you get out there and do that. Somebody call her and sing happy birthday tomorrow, okay? Somebody do that. Somebody call her and sing to her. That might be me. I might be the one to just do that. Get her on the phone and just sing to that girl. That's what I might do. You just never know. All right, folks, it is time to cruise on into 2 Samuel. 2 Samuel. We're going over to chapter 15. Chapter 15. Remember, we will be here Monday and Tuesday of next week. But after that, folks, I can't guarantee due to my move. All right? And so you want to stay up to date here. You want to stay up to date on my page, okay, as to what we are, where we are, what's going to go on. So I tell you what, Brian, our friend Brian is really struggling to wake up. Brian, are you still on? Hey, Brian, you here? Let me hear from you. Brian, if you were here, this is just for you, Brian. Get up, Brian. Get up. Get up. Get up, Brian. Yeah, speaking of roosters, I'm mowing my yard in Wynn, Arkansas yesterday. I'm not even kidding. I'm mowing my yard, and there is a rooster going off somewhere in my neighborhood. I'm not even kidding you. And I'm looking around like, there is a rooster in the city limits of Wynn. And that dude went off all morning. I mean, he was a happy camper. He was a happy camper, and he was introducing himself to us, letting us know that it's here, and I thought, we have just found the right spot to know that I've got a rooster for real in my hood. So I thought, that is just perfect. But I told Mr. Lee, I said, you ain't going to believe this. I said, we got a stupid rooster in the neighborhood. And I mean, this old boy, hey, dude, he's loud. You know, you would think he was next door, but I know he wasn't. Yeah, I mean, he really wasn't. But loud, good Lord, he was loud. So that means he is a cocky little rascal. So I'm looking forward to being introduced to Roscoe the Rooster. I'm just going to call him Roscoe. So we're going to figure him out where he's down there. So all of that is going on. Man, just all kinds of fun things. You just never know what we're going to find right here on the coffee chat. It is all that good stuff. So today, today is really lightweight stuff in 2 Samuel. If you remember yesterday, okay, David sent Zadok and the Levites back. Take the Ark of the Covenant back. We're going to put this all in God's hands. It's not going to be up to me. It's going to be up to God. If God wants me back, and he wants me back where that Ark of the Covenant is, then he's going to put me back on that throne. And if not, then I'm going to trust him. That's trust. That's the king. That's King David. That's the man we learned who was going to be, or who he was going to be, in the wilderness back when he was being chased by King Saul. So today, we're going to read a couple of verses. We're going to start at verse 27, and we're still talking to Zadok, the priest, okay? This is kind of like final instructions that David is giving Zadok before he and the Levites go back to Jerusalem, cross back over the brook Kidron, and take the Ark of the Covenant back into the city. And this is what he says. We pick up at verse 27. The king also said, again, a reference to David as the king, okay? The writer here wants you and I to totally understand that even though Absalom is showing his rear end and trying to take over the throne and to assert himself as the king of Israel, we need to understand something. Nothing has changed. David is still king. And so we have the king also said to Zadok. He said to Zadok the priest, are you not a seer? Now, a seer is somebody that we would call that has kind of like supernatural insight. They've got this highly attentive gut feeling. They can observe things that are not quite there. And seers were very popular during this time. Kings had them around them as counselors, as advisors. Well, evidently, Zadok was one, and Zadok was a good one, okay? And so what we have here is the king says to Zadok the priest, are you not a seer? Kind of like, I think I might have triggered something. return to the city in peace, and your two sons with you, Ahimaaz your son, and Jonathan the son of Abiathar. In other words, don't go just by yourself. Take the covenant with you, and to go back and oversee this. All right, I want you to make sure it's done and done right. Verse 28, see, I will wait in the plains of the wilderness until word comes from you to inform to me. In other words, you're going back as a spy for me. You're going to gather information. You're the seer. You're going to be the one who's going to be able to detect what is and isn't going on long before it actually happens. And so that's your role. That's what I need you to do, Zadok. Take these two guys, go back, send me information. And he says, I'm going to wait in the plains of the wilderness until word comes from you to inform me. Therefore, Zadok and Abiathar carried the Ark of God back to Jerusalem, and they remained there. Okay, what do we have here? Again, loyalty. And this is what we've really stressed all week long. It's loyalty. Even when it appears that the leader is going downhill, that everybody is turning against the leader, they remain loyal. Because they knew that David was God's man. They knew that Absalom was not. He was trying to insert himself. And we see that a lot of times in companies. We see that a lot of times in churches. People assume and assert themselves into leadership above God's man. And these guys were loyal. I mean, hyper-loyal. We've already looked at Ittai, the definition of loyalty. And now we see Zadok now willing to go back into the city where all of the chaos and the turmoil is actually going to be taking place, yet to do what he is called to do, which is the priest and the priestly duties to oversee the Ark of the Covenant, but also to serve as the seer for King David. Loyalty. It's critical. And it pays off for David. It was critical in the life of David and to what happens from this point forward. Monday, Lord willing, Monday, we're going to come back here and we're going to see the breaking point, if you will, of King David. His heart is breaking. He's hurting. He's mourning. Because he knows what's going on. He knows the people that's followed him. And he knows what's about to happen in the city. And so whatever you do not miss the mourning of King David. That'll be Monday morning at 9 o'clock, Lord willing. I definitely hope I can see you then. If you guys get a chance, get on out, enjoy the sunshine. If you're going to work in your yard, get it done before lunch today, folks. Because again, last minute look at the radar Omega, and it is crossing, getting closer. Okay, so we are going to see it. So you definitely want to be careful not to get caught out in it. Know this, I love you guys more than you will ever realize. More than you will ever realize. If you need me, reach out to me. I'll see you guys on Sunday. Looking forward to church on Sunday. And if you see anybody, tell them about Jesus. I'll see you guys. Bye-bye.